Okay, now that CAT and IFT are done with, the next important paper is SNAP. There are changes in SNAP this year. Current affairs has vanished. I'm sure many of you will be heaving a sigh of relief. Also, please remember, current affairs, while there was worth 30 marks last year with 25 odd questions, the fact is most of the students would not have scored more than 4, 5 or maybe 6 marks. Okay, so the last year's cutoff of 75 odd marks for the top two symbols in institutes would have gone down to about 70 marks if you remove the current affairs portion. Okay, it saves you another 10 minutes which you can probably use for quant, DIN, quant, reasoning and English. Okay, the other major change in this paper this year is that reasoning and English all questions are worth 1.5 marks, while quant 30 questions are worth 1 mark and 5 questions are worth 2 marks. Okay, how does that impact you? First of all, last year, given the fact that English was worth 1 mark each, this year it's become 1.5 mark, the attempts will not go up, but you'll get more marks for it. So this is likely to increase your score by about 10 to 12 marks. Similarly, reasoning, by and large, you'll increase your score, but reasoning last year was there was both 1 and 2 mark questions. So you'll gain maybe about 3-4 marks there. But at the same time, you'll lose 5 marks odd of current affairs. So which means last year's 75 will be equivalent to something like 82 to 85 this year. So assuming the same level of difficulty as last year's SNAP, this year an equivalent score is likely to be about 82 to 85 marks. Okay. Now let's come to what you should be doing in terms of preparation. Let's go section by section. English, do exactly what you have done for. In fact, English and reasoning do exactly what you have done for NMAT. Questions are similar, types are similar, the level of difficulty is similar. You will always have in English those 4-5 questions which are stupid, which are parts of speech, which are asking you definitions of various grammatical terms and so on and so forth. If you know, great. If you don't know, just leave them. Similarly, when you're looking at the reasoning section, the problem many times which is there is there are few visual reasoning questions which are difficult. And like IFT, SNAP also has a habit of introducing some incorrect questions. Okay, to be charitable, I'll say they are doing it by out of choice, but the fact is it's a mistake which is there. Invariably, every year we find a few questions to be incorrect and wherein you end up wasting time. Otherwise, it is not a difficult paper, and because people waste a lot of time in those incorrect questions, they end up not having sufficient time for the other easy questions. Similarly, quant, it's not going to be IFT kind, lengthy questions. It is not going to be CAT kind, which is the difficult question. It is your NMAT. So if there's one paper you can benchmark to SNAP in terms of level of difficulty, in terms of kind of question, it is NMAT. Both are very similar. The only difference is when you look at SNAP, in the reasoning section, it also has the visual reasoning part. The verbal reasoning is easy, not a problem. You'll have those strength and weaken questions. You'll have statement conclusion questions. Okay. Similarly, analytical reasoning is not difficult, though there might be one odd set which is either incorrect or difficult. Okay. And as I said, visual reasoning is an issue. English, you'll have a simple RC, you'll have simple vocabulary questions and so on and so forth. Maths again is, as I said earlier, like NMAT, focus is by and large going to be on the area called arithmetic. Okay. How should you take the paper? Keep it simple. 3 sections. English is a section which you can by and large complete in something like 20-25 minutes, worst case 30 minutes. The other two sections are the ones which will take time. So a simple structure of 30-45-45 could be the starting point for you. So you look at saying that 30 minutes for English, 45 minutes for reasoning and 45 for quant. Supposing you happen to be very good in reasoning and you say, no, I want to give 50 minutes and I'll cut down 5 minutes for quant, not an issue at all, the reverse could also be done. English, do not give less than 25 minutes. That's a section you should comfortably complete. Please don't rush through the paper at all. Remember in IFT, we had been saying continuously, make sure you give sufficient time to English. And if you had given 35 to 40 minutes to English, you could have got as high as 80 marks in IFT in English itself. The same thing is true for SNAP also. If you are willing to give 25, maybe 30 minutes to English, no problem at all. You will again end up getting a reasonably good score. 40 odd or 42 odd is not difficult in English. Okay. Reasoning and maths is the one you'll have to say which is my stronger area and focus more on that. Okay. So just to conclude, just to sum it up, 30 minutes English, 45 reasoning, 45 maths. The sequence can be as per your preference. I will not prescribe that, though I personally would normally do is 30 minutes English, then go to reasoning, 45 minutes, and then go to quant. Okay. In any case, in your aspiration account, you will have the older SNAP papers. Please make sure you do the reasoning from the older SNAP papers definitely to get a hang of the kind of question which come there. For more information, for more inputs on how to prepare for SNAP and what are the other things you should be looking out for SNAP, please go to currylauncher.com/cat-mba/snap. Okay? So all the best. We'll come back again with more inputs for you.